Hello, this is NOAA Administrator Dr. Jane Lubchenco. Did you know that two-thirds of all of the goods we buy come to us by ship? Marine commerce has tripled in the last 50 years and continues to grow, contributing nearly $1 trillion and more than 13 million jobs to our economy. In fact, 95% of all U.S. trade involves some form of maritime transportation. The nation's marine transportation infrastructure is, in a word, massive. More than 25,000 miles of waterways and 3,700 marine terminals move high volumes of goods, services, and people through the nation and to points abroad. In fact, 10 of America's busiest ports are responsible for 95% of container shipping. One of those is the Port of New Orleans, long considered America's gateway to the global marketplace. With a rich tradition of maritime trade dating back to 1718, the Big Easy lies at the nexus of the world's busiest port complex, Louisiana's Lower Mississippi River. Nearly 160,000 jobs and $8 billion in annual earnings are generated by the port. More than 6,000 ships travel through New Orleans each year, moving 8 million tons or more of imported commercial and consumer goods from the seas to store shelves. That is a lot of traffic. Sadly, this year, more than 3,500 ships will be involved in accidents along the nation's congested waterways. Accidents such as costly ship groundings and potentially lethal collisions.
If there was a stoppage of traffic on the river, which we actually had last year in July, the estimates were that it impacted the nation at $250 million a day.
Not only are more vessels passing through our ports, but they are bigger than they have ever been and are pushing the limits of channel depth and bridge clearance. As we look to marine transportation as an energy-efficient alternative to overland and air transport, ports like New Orleans must balance increasing maritime commerce with the safety of mariners, fishermen, cargo, and the environment. It's a hefty challenge, but NOAA's Ports Program is helping to change that. Short for Physical Oceanographic Real-Time System, Ports provides ship pilots and mariners the essential tide, current, bridge clearance, and weather data they need to navigate America's crowded waterways safely and efficiently. Created by NOAA's Center for Operational Oceanographic Products and Services, or COOPS, Ports is a sophisticated observing system that operates 24/7, 365 days a year, with data available on demand via the web or by phone. The system can now be found in 20 locations, including the Great Lakes, the West and East Coasts, Alaska, and the Gulf of Mexico.
We're getting information now that we would have never gotten before. Real-time clearances or real-time current velocities. We're excited about it.
During data testing trials for the Lower Mississippi ports, the system's precision air gap technology, which uses real-time sensors to continuously monitor bridge clearance, enabled a new $1 billion Navy ship, the USS New York, to pass safely down the Mississippi River and clear the Huey P. Long Bridge just north of downtown New Orleans with 2 feet to spare. I joined senior representatives from the U.S. Coast Guard and the Port of New Orleans to celebrate the completion of the Lower Mississippi River ports, which now includes air gap installations at both the Huey P. Long and Crescent City bridges, as well as currents and other types of sensors along the river.
In the past, to calculate vertical clearance, bridge clearance for the ships to pass under, we do a rough calculation based on static information using the river stage to get an estimated clearance.
And you really didn't know exactly what the clearance was. For instance, on a hot day with cars jammed on a bridge, you could get 3 to 4 foot sag in that bridge. So, but with ports now, we'll have an icon that we can engage, and it'll immediately give you a graphic view of either Crescent City connection or the Huey P. Long Bridge and the real-time bridge clearance of both of those bridges.
Having that information is a confidence builder in making our decisions, and it'll definitely go a long way in enhancing safety and navigation here on the Mississippi River.
High-quality ports data are helping to prevent groundings and collisions, in some areas by more than 50%. In the case of a hazardous spill, ports data are critical to mounting a rapid and effective containment response and cleanup. The system also supports important wetland restoration and protection projects in the greater southeast Louisiana area, and is a part of NOAA's observation systems that monitor sea level rise, storm surge, and tropical storms, fulfilling a great need in this hurricane-battered region. With NOAA ports, mariners from near and far will have the tools and the confidence to move valuable goods in and out of America's busiest commercial waterways safely and efficiently. Until next time, this is Jane Lubchenco.